Okay, good afternoon class. Today we'll be starting our chapter 15, that is on probability distribution. Okay. Now, in this chapter we'll be learning things like discrete random variables and to construct a probability distribution for a discrete random variable. We're going to construct a table. Okay? So now I would like to ask you all, you see, you know about numerical data. Numerical data divided into two components, that's one discrete and one. State the possible values of X. You know that the total probability should be 1. So state the possible values of X. That means to obtain the number 6, just like how you flip the coin just now. So you might get no number 6 appearing at all. 1 number 6 appearing, 2 number 6 at one time, and you can get all number 6 appearing at the same time. Am I right?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So this is one of the possible values of X. Okay, now, construct a probability distribution table. Before we can construct a probability distribution table, just like what your MPM wants you, after doing all your working, you need to present your answer in a table form. Okay? So let's look at it. To get and obtain a number 6, you should be 1 out of 6. If you do not want to get a number 6 doesn't appear, it will be 5 out of 6. Okay, that means A prime. Okay, A will be number 6 is obtained on the dice. Okay, now let's start doing the process. When there is no number 6, there is probability of not obtaining number 6, not obtaining number 6, not obtaining number 6. 3 times. Because why? There are 3 dice that are rolled simultaneously at the same time. Okay? So not appearing number 6 will be 5 over 6. Multiply 5 over 6 times by 5 over 6. I should get 125 out of 216. If something that can be reduced, we should reduce it. But here, we don't have anything to reduce. Okay? So we carry on. Number 6, obtaining, not obtaining. You're going to get a number 6, not obtaining number 6, and obtaining again a number 6. Chances are there. Okay? Not obtaining, obtaining, and obtaining, the same process follows. Suddenly, you might get all number 6 appears. Okay? When you know that you are getting a number 6 is 1 out of 6. So, 1 over 6, you multiply by another 1 over 6, and you multiply 1 over 6, you get this. Okay, now, later you need to present your data in a, you need to tabulate the whole thing. I'm going to maybe do it below here with a black pen, ink, and then you can see it. Answer is 125 out of 216. When I'm going to get a number 6, it's going to be 75 out of 216. For twice of the number 6, 15 out of 216. And a no, and a all number 6 should be 1 over 216. That's it. Okay? So total probability, what you're going to see is you add up everything and you are going to get equals to 1.